Good evening. This is All India Radio and I'm Tanvi Taneja with the news at 9. The headlines. Both houses of parliament witnessed repeated adjournments of a standoff between CBI and West Bengal police. Home Minister Rajnath Singh says the issue is an indication of constitutional breakdown. Supreme Court to hear CBI's contempt plea tomorrow against Kolkata police officers for obstructing probe in Saradha chit-fund case. Calcutta High Court refuses immediate hearing on West Bengal government's plea against the CBI action. Indian Banking Association issues advisory to banks to waive off processing and all other service charges for Kisan Credit Card and crop loans up to 3 lakh rupees. Over 5 crore people take holy dip at Kumbh in Prayagraj on Mauni Amavasya today. And in cricket, India grabs the second spot in the ICC One Day International rankings. Virat Kohli and Jasprit Bumrah continue to top batsmen and bowlers ranking. Both houses of parliament faced repeated adjournments today over the standoff between the CBI and the West Bengal police in Kolkata last evening. When the Lok Sabha met in the post-lunch session after adjournments in the morning, TMC, Congress, RJD, SP and other parties raised the CBI issue again and several members trooped into the well and shouted slogans. Some Congress members were also in the well over the Rafael deal. Speaker Sumitra Mahajan urged the agitating members to allow the House to function. Parliamentary Affairs Minister Narendra Singh Tomar also appealed to the members to take up the business, but the protesting members did not pay any heed. The Speaker then adjourned the House for the day. Earlier, replying to opposition members who raised the issue during the zero hour, Home Minister Rajnath Singh, amidst the pandemonium, said that the standoff between the CBI and the West Bengal police is an indication towards constitutional breakdown and asserted that the constitution has given responsibility to the centre to ensure that the system functions as per the constitution.
कल कलकत्ता में सीबीआई के अधिकारियों को लॉफुल ड्यूटीज को करने से न केवल रोका गया बल्कि उन्हें कलकत्ता पुलिस द्वारा पुलिस थाने में डिटेन किया गया। मैं समझता हूं कि ऐसी घटना देश के इतिहास में अनप्रेसिडेंटेड है।
The Home Minister said the way the state police acted against the CBI is a grave threat to the federal system. He said he has sought a detailed report from West Bengal governor over the issue. Mr. Singh defended CBI action against Kolkata Police Commissioner, saying the agency was forced to act as the officer was not cooperating in the probe. He said there was allegation of nexus between politicians and influential persons in the scam and the agency is probing the matter as per the direction of the Supreme Court. Earlier, TMC member Saugat Roy raised the issue and said the centre is constantly using CBI to throttle the opposition. He said the CBI action poses a constitutional crisis. Congress leader Mallikarjun Kharge charged that the CBI is being used as a weapon to finish the opposition. He said the opposition will not succumb to such pressure.
ये सरकार सीबीआई को एक हथियार बनाकर सभी अपोजिशन लीडर को खत्म करना चाहती है कौन सा कानून ऐसा बोलता है कि रात के 7 बजे जाकर आप एक पुलिस ऑफिसर को अरेस्ट करें
बीजू जनता दल लीडर भर्तृहरि मेहताब अलेज्ड दैट सीबीआई इज एक्टिंग एज अ पॉलिटिकल स्टूज एंड क्वेश्चन द इंटेग्रिटी ऑफ द इन्वेस्टिगेटिव एजेंसी Dharmendra Yadav of Samajwadi Party, Supriya Sule of NCP and Jay Prakash Narayan Yadav of RJD also echoed similar views and condemned the CBI action. Questioning the CBI action, Badruddoza Khan of CPIM, however, attacked the West Bengal government over the situation. TMC MP Somitra Khan, who recently switched over to the BJP, accused Mamata Banerjee government of not allowing BJP programs in the state. During the Home Minister's reply, TMC, RJD, SP and TDP members trooped into the well raising slogans. The scene was no different in the Rajya Sabha. When the House reassembled at 2 p.m. after the first adjournment, members from TMC, SP and several other opposition parties trooped into the well raising slogans against the government over CBI action in the state. Some ruling BJP members were also on their feet to counter the opposition charges. Amid noisy scenes, Chairman M. Venkaiah Naidu adjourned the House for the day minutes after it met. Earlier in the morning, TMC-led opposition created uproar over the same issue. TMC MP Derek O'Brien raised the issue, alleging that the CBI is being misused by the centre for political reasons. The Supreme Court will hear CBI's plea tomorrow, alleging contempt against Kolkata police officers for obstructing the probe and for destruction of evidence in Saradha case. The agency today moved the top court, seeking directions to the West Bengal government to cooperate with the investigation in the chit-fund cases, and has sought to make available Police Commissioner Rajiv Kumar. Solicitor General Tushar Mehta, appearing for CBI, told the Supreme Court that an extraordinary situation has arisen and sought urgent hearing this afternoon. The court, however, fixed the matter for tomorrow. The Calcutta High Court today refused immediate hearing on the West Bengal government's plea against the CBI's attempt to question City Police Commissioner Rajiv Kumar at his residence in connection with chit fund scam cases. Following objection by the union government, Justice Shivakant Prasad refused to give the matter an immediate hearing and listed it for tomorrow. State Advocate General Kishore Datta submitted that despite a stay by the High Court on steps regarding notice to state police officials, the CBI sought to enter Kumar's residence yesterday and question him. Additional Solicitor General Kaushik Chanda submitted that the CBI has already moved the Supreme Court on the order of which the central agency is investigating the chit fund cases, and as such, the hearing on the state's prayer be adjourned. This is All India Radio giving you the news. For quick news updates, follow us on Twitter at AIR News Alerts.
Papa, हमारा पक्का घर बन जाने पर नया सामान लोगे ना?
क्या क्या चाहिए हमारी बेटिया रानी को?
हॉल में रखने के लिए टेलीविजन.
अच्छा, और
मम्मी के लिए किचन का सामान और पापा घर के अंदर एक टॉयलेट. हमको टॉयलेट के लिए बाहर ना जाना पड़े.
जरूर बेटी. अच्छा और बताओ, रानी बेटी को पहले क्या क्या चाहिए?
मेरे लिए एक स्टडी टेबल, चेयर और किताबें रखने के लिए एक अलमारी.
हाँ, हमारी बेटी पढ़ लिख कर बड़ी अफसर बनेगी.
क्यों रानी को झूठे सपने दिखा रहे हो?
अरे ये सच है. ये देखो हमारा लेटर, प्रधानमंत्री आवास योजना शहरी स्कीम के अंतर्गत अब हमारे पक्के घर का अधूरा सपना होगा पूरा.
सच?
जी हाँ, अब सबके सपने हो रहे हैं पूरे. प्रधानमंत्री आवास योजना शहरी स्कीम के अंतर्गत मिलने वाले घरों से लाखों लोगों ने अपने घर का सपना किया है पूरा. अधिक जानकारी के लिए अपने स्थानीय शहरी निकाय से संपर्क करें.
हाउसिंग फॉर ऑल, सबके लिए घर, ये हमारा सपना भी है और संकल्प भी है.
आज प्लास्टिक पोल्यूशन से नदी और समुद्र में मछलियां और कछुए मर रहे हैं, और सड़कों पर मवेशी भी. पर आप चाहें तो इसे रोक सकते हैं अपना डोनेशन देकर. डोनेशन देने के लिए अगली बार जब बाजार जाएं तो कपड़े या जूट का बैग साथ ले जाएं और प्लास्टिक का बैग इस्तेमाल ना करें.
आपका ये छोटा सा डोनेशन है पर्यावरण में बड़ा योगदान, और यही है आपका ग्रीन गुड डीड. ग्रीन गुड डीड्स मतलब कुछ हरे भरे काम अपनी धरती के नाम. पर्यावरण वन एवं जलवायु परिवर्तन मंत्रालय द्वारा पर्यावरण हित में जारी.
वेलकम बैक, यू आर लिसनिंग टू द न्यूज एट 9. The BJP today rejected the allegation of political vendetta through CBI action and alleged that West Bengal Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee is shielding the corrupts in Sharda Chitfund scam. Briefing reporters in New Delhi, BJP leader Ravi Shankar Prasad attacked Ms. Banerjee for sitting on dharna along with the police commissioner. He said many TMC leaders, including Sudeep Bandyopadhyay, were arrested in the scam, but the chief minister never sat on dharna then. Mr. Prasad said the agency is working as per the direction of the Supreme Court because poor people have lost their money in the chitfund scam.
ये जो भ्रष्ट लोगों का गठबंधन है जो ये बताने की कोशिश कर रहा है कि राजनीतिक दुर्भावना से कार्रवाई हो रही है, तो पहले उनको एक बात का जवाब देना पड़ेगा. क्या भ्रष्टाचार की जांच करना पाप है? क्या सुप्रीम कोर्ट के निर्देश पर सीबीआई अगर बड़ी संख्या में हजारों करोड़ में रोज वैली स्कैम, शारदा स्कैम, जहां छोटे निवेशकों के पैसे लूटे गए, उसकी जांच करना क्या पाप है?
The BJP delegation, including Defence Minister Nirmala Sitharaman and party leader Mukhtar Abbas Naqvi, met Election Commission today over the West Bengal issue. Talking to media after the meeting, Ms. Sitharaman said They brought to the notice of the commission the incidents in West Bengal which occurred in connivance with Trinamool Congress.
Certain happenings in West Bengal, which has complete cooperation of the party in power in Bengal, the Trinamool Congress, and the instances that we highlighted before the Election Commission, clearly point out that the government in Bengal, run by Trinamool Congress, does not believe in democracy, is out there with all its workers, making sure that political parties don't get a space for conducting their legitimate activities.
Rishi Kumar Shukla today took charge as the Director of Central Bureau of Investigation, CBI. He took charge from M. Nageshwar Rao, who was working as Interim Chief of the Investigating Agency. Mr. Shukla will serve in the post for a period of 2 years. 1983 batch IPS officer of Madhya Pradesh cadre, Mr. Shukla has also served as DGP of Madhya Pradesh. The Indian Banking Association has issued advisory requesting banks to waive off the processing, documentation, inspection and all other service charges for Kisan Credit Card and crop loans up to 3 lakh rupees. The Agriculture Ministry said in a release that there are over 21 crore small and marginal farmers in the country, and providing them timely and affordable credit is the key to attaining inclusive growth. The Kisan Credit Card scheme aims at providing adequate and timely credit support from the banking system to the farmers to meet the short-term credit requirements for cultivation and allied activities. The government today decided to launch a campaign to saturate farmers for financial inclusion under Kisan Credit Cards, KCC. The Agriculture Ministry, in a statement, said the campaign will be launched through the financial institutions in collaboration with the state governments. The Department of Financial Services has already issued directives to the financial institutions in this regard. On the occasion of Mauni Amavasya, more than 5 crore devotees took holy bath at Kumbh in Prayagraj today. This was the second Shahi Snan in which saints and seers of different akhadas took the holy dip. Uttar Pradesh Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath greeted people on the occasion. Our correspondent says the importance of the day has increased multifold, as this time Mauni Amavasya fell on Monday after several years during the Kumbh.
The devotees started reaching Sangam area since yesterday. 40 Snan ghats have been prepared along 8 km length to manage huge crowd of pilgrims. Display and dance of saints and seers of different akharas were center of attraction. Union Minister and Mahamandaleshwar of Akhara, Sadhvi Niranjan Jyoti, and Deputy Chief Minister of Uttar Pradesh, Keshav Prasad Maurya, along with dozens of MPs and MLAs, were amongst those who took holy dip today. MS Yadav, Area News, Kumbh Mela, Prayagraj.
Indian cricket team has grabbed the second spot in the ICC One Day International rankings following recent success in Australia and New Zealand. In batsmen's rankings, Indian captain Virat Kohli and Jasprit Bumrah in bowlers' rankings continue to top the charts. India have accumulated 122 points for series wins over Australia and New Zealand and are placed behind England with 126 points. In business news, the benchmark BSE Sensex today recovered from the day's low to end 113 points higher amid fresh inflows by foreign funds ahead of the RBI's monetary policy review. However, the rupee weakened 55 paise. And the News Services Division of All India Radio, in its weekly bilingual live phone-in program, Public Speak, will bring you a discussion tonight on Naye Bharat Ki Gati, Akankshaon Aur Nirman Ka Budget, Budget 2019. This can be heard on the FM Gold channel and additional frequencies from 9:30 p.m. And now, before we end the bulletin, the headlines once again. Both houses of parliament witness repeated adjournments of a standoff between CBI and the West Bengal police. Home Minister Rajnath Singh says the issue is an indication of constitutional breakdown. Supreme Court to hear CBI's contempt plea tomorrow against Kolkata police officers for obstructing probe in Saradha chit-fund case. Calcutta High Court refuses immediate hearing on West Bengal government's plea against the CBI action. Indian Banking Association issues advisory to banks to waive off processing and all other service charges for Kisan Credit Card and crop loans up to 3 lakh rupees. Over 5 crore people take holy dip at Kumbh in Prayagraj on Mauni Amavasya today. And in cricket, India grabs second spot in the ICC One Day International rankings Virat Kohli and Jasprit Bumrah continue to top batsmen and bowlers rankings. And that is all in the news at 9. Good night.